The Fukushima catastrophe is probably the worst nuclear disaster in human history. It's certainly worse than Chernobyl.
It's October the 20th, 2015. I'm Dana Drenfurt, also known as nuclearproctologist.org, and you can find my videos at Beautiful Girl Boy Dana on YouTube. And we are streaming live each day, 5 days a week. The new time is 10:30 a.m. Pacific Canada time. And I'm in British Columbia, Powell River. And what we're doing is we are putting out episodes.
It's October the 20th, 2015.
And streaming live.
Also known as Nuclear
Proctologist. And that name was conceived on the toilet. And I'm not kidding you. We were trying to come up with a name for the website. And it was just one of those unusual times where I went into the bathroom and I had visitors. And I started laughing. And somebody yelled at me, "What are you laughing about in there?" And I said, "I got it, the nuclear proctologist." And everybody was laughing for the next 5 minutes, couldn't have a proper poo. But the nuclear proctologist was born. And we are today streaming live at Beautiful Girl by Dana, and we're going to cover radiation children in Japan. And so, you know, a lot of people will isolate it to Fukushima Prefecture or something. I'm not going to do that because that's not the way radiation works. What's there is here is everywhere. And beware that they'll tell you it's like a banana or a potato chip or walking in the sunshine or getting on an airplane. And people that tell you that, by the way, are lawyers and they know better. And they don't get up in the media because they tell the truth. And I know I'm not going to go down that road with everybody. But today's headlines in episode 6, which is episode 7, counting the pilot show, and you'll find a link to the pilot show below. And that's Unit 1 and Unit 2 in the pilot show. And Unit 3 was the next show. The next show is Unit 4 and the next show. And so we're up to number 6, which is actually number 7. I might have to go back and change that at some stage because it gets confusing trying to have a conversation about it. 75 times higher. That's what they raised the radiation levels. Not all the kids, it's an acceptable level. Oh, how did it get accepted? Well, he raised the level. Who did? Well, I don't know. The guy with the $5,000 suit on. Who is he? Nobody knows. Was there a debate about it? No. Was there a vote on it? And anybody who's not familiar, that's me just being Dana. So you had an earthquake. You had a tsunami, you had detonations, you had radioactive fallout, you had salacious statements. Now, you can't have a conversation about Japan or about melted reactors, go figure, without sounding like an alarmist, without sounding like you're a firemongering. And so it's easy to attach that label to somebody without giving them, you know, an opportunity. And so what they're doing is taking away that other narrative from everybody by doing that to me all the time. Now, I was just looking for those Harvard, MIT, and everything else. And I just got so much on my computer, sometimes I can't keep up with it. Here's what Stanford said a couple of days after Fukushima happened, just so I can get the next headline set up for everybody.
Stanford University.
We are very, very lucky today to have two real experts on this topic. The first is Matthew Wald from the New York Times.
Oh, I smurfed that up, did I? I cut Matthew off. Hang on, I'll find him. Dana. Dana can't take you anywhere, Dana. Do the last 10 seconds, buddy.
...to try to cope with a meltdown, or three meltdowns in the spent fuel pool right after a tsunami.
Uh-huh. So, yeah, destroyed. Wap-a-pulley! Boom! Radioactive iodine was found in 50% of the children's thyroids. 35,000 microsieverts. 50%. Now, they just came out with a study saying 2,700 children were tested in Fukushima Prefecture, and none of them had any issues. We'll see about that. Nursery school, Geiger counter nearly off the scale near play equipment. Now, as we go through these headlines and these other stuff that I got here for us in this 1 hour show, in episode 6, what I'm really going to be probably showing you more than anything else is the tragedy. And, you know, these people have suffered. So before I go down that path, just let me remind everybody how devastating just the event of the earthquake and tsunami and, you know, the tsunami, think about what that done. Is that your house? So you're not emotionally attached to what you see there, but a lot of people are. And a lot of them are dead, of course. But for the people that experienced this, you know, this is traumatic in every sense of the word. And it will have a trigger effect till the end of time on their grandchildren and great-grandchildren, if they're fortunate enough to have one. This is a tsunami. That's the earthquake doing that. But here's a tsunami coming up, coming ashore for 500 miles of coastline. See, the birds just barely escape. And as that wave hits, another one's right behind it at 600 miles an hour, and another one behind that, and another one behind that. And then 500 miles of coastline looks like this, sustained. And I likened it in the last couple of videos to a wood chipper of just unimaginable proportions. If that was your home and you were up there taking a picture or taking that video, what would be going through your head? It wouldn't be your home, it'd be that entire neighborhood is now eradicated. And just that grief, that overwhelming sense of loss, of separation from reality.
The buildings and homes of some 9,000.
You have to go on with life, yeah?
They've all been swept away.
And so it wasn't just the tsunami, this earthquake, this is Tokyo, this lasted 6 minutes. This 6 minutes of the country being shaken like a blanket in a storm. And these shock waves are traveling at around 9,000 miles an hour across your country. And so your country is, say, 400 or 500 miles long. And so the shock wave just shoots right through your country with enormous amount of energy. And then many countries in surrounding the Pacific Rim nations, you know, at 9,000 miles an hour, this is coming through the earth. Think about how a bass on a car works when it's driving past you. You're not in the car, but you can feel that bass. You know that thing got bass. You know that. And it's not just because it's loud, it's because you can actually feel it, but it's a subconscious thing. And so this whole country was wrecked. Everything was wrecked. Buildings, just because you're seeing pavement wrecked, does that mean the buildings weren't torn apart or cracked and that the people in it wasn't traumatized hundreds of miles away from the epic center? Fukushima was the epic center, right? And so Fukushima, 50 minutes later, this creature come flying through your country for 500 miles and takes out the entire country, takes out the entire infrastructure, takes out the entire security blanket that people sunk, you know, 30 years of mortgage into these houses with the hopes that they were going to have a... That's the ghetto's laugh. I often think what and how I would feel if I went through that. Many times. Is the problem, I guess. But Geiger counter's nearly off the scale. Why did they have to suffer with that? Government of South of Tokyo, 12,400 becquerels. Next to children's swimming pools. Why, after all the suffering, would you do that to those children? Why would you traumatize them, finish them off? Why not give them an opportunity? You'd be better off moving to Chernobyl. And I don't say that lightly. You're better off moving to Chernobyl. Chernobyl was only like that. That's pretty darn good compared to Japan. Japan had never stopped. Hiroshima stopped after 10 days. But it's equal to 400 Hiroshima bombs. That's why it looks like that. All of Europe. UK, Ireland, Scotland. You still can't sell land down there in certain parts that was contaminated by this fallout 28 years ago. What do you think is happening in Japan? Once again, you know, that's the gallows laugh you're hearing. That's all that is. It's just that, as you think about it, school, playground, staircases, radiation is 70 times maximum allowable. Well, that's all. You raised the limit to 75 times maximum allowable. There's still got a good 5 times left here before it's dangerous, sir. Yeah, and who helped you tie up your shoes this morning is the question you're supposed to ask that person. Equal to the radiation control area itself. Find it. Because if I don't look here, I won't find it. Hang on. Okay, but anyway, there was a story of children, 2,700 children being tested and never found no radiation. But September 20th, corporation, so the government wouldn't have to deal with it, but so it would be left there. Done. So the government could never clean it up on purpose. So it would pollute that whole environment on purpose. That is the structure of all nuclear holding sites. Hang on. Dana. Conspiracy theorist, Dana. Well, if you look at the nuclear drums, go put a 45-gallon drum in your garden, leave it there for about 5 years, and then go try to sell it on eBay. But, I mean, it's not just that. It's nuclear fuel storage. Look at the tonnages again. What do you think that's doing in your thing all the time in a chain reaction? That's why Chernobyl was equal to 400 Hiroshima bombs after 10 days. But then it stopped. If it lasted 20 days, it would be 800 Hiroshima bombs. It was 30 days, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So do the math on 3 melter, 100% melting down. It's in the pool because it's out of the pool. It's still just like the stuff that's in the reactor. But that's what they took. They took it out of the reactor and put it in the pool to let it cool down for a few years or decades. And so let me run back to the headlines on the children. So that's, you know, one coming up. One that pilot episode thrown in there. But I'll get it right because I'll go and switch the names. Let's go. 300,000 children going to school so contaminated they'd be... Right, that's it, just that one headline. Just that one showed you and going to show you. Top cancer doctor. Nuclear radiation, most carcinogenic thing that exists. I was going to say something else. Head of Tokyo. I try to keep it like a family oriented. Head of Tokyo here. Dig up every house in Japan and put it on a nuclear waste site. And dig up 6 feet of topsoil throughout Japan. And knock down every tree in Japan. And drain every river and lake and that stuff back in there. You got to take those stations on. These are frightening. Every one of these. Nursery school taking field trips so kids can play in areas with less radioactivity. Chernobyl got less activity than any spot they're going to go to earthquake and explain to you the significance of. Not that I know what I'm looking for even right now, but I'm looking. I might find it. You never know. Give me a chance. Just give me. Okay, there it is. I knew I was looking for something I had down there somewhere. according to Japan's Nuclear and Safety Agency. About to go without pension soon. The earthquake. And then I'm going to make the headlines. Blurp, blurp. Common level by radioactive compost made by elementary school kids. Using fallen leaves. That's what I mean. You got to get rid of all the trees. If you wanted to decontaminate the country, you got to plow it all dry, 150 times background. Dr. Raymond Gilmitty. Might want to... in the skeleton in the liver occurred beginning of about 3 years out. That's what I'm doing. I'm imitating a nuclear scientist now. And I got an email saying that this person who cleans up... conference rooms, there was a big meeting and apparently they were discussing me and a lot of nuclear scientists are having me do. Let me keep going. But anyway, lung tumor, and I will humiliate myself and Zoe. No, no, just a homeless, Dana. Does your mommy or daddy work for nuclear industry? You should every day say, mommy and daddy, why don't you go down to Chernobyl and help them? They got no one there, only homeless people. You're so big and tall and strong and smart, jack shit. I'm just a radioactive fallout zones in Chernobyl. Parents and kids don't have doors screaming like a little sissy. Children. Yeah. Well, solid cancers take a long time. Reactors cannot prevent radiation. Well, your white blood cells flood your body when the radiation's in your body and makes that solid cancer. But that takes normally a long time. But if you're sucking up a lot of it and it's sequestering in the same area, oops, not good for you, little Timmy. Local government, 276,000 becquerels kilogram. Almost 18 million becquerels in a meter. I can't remember what the numbers were. Was it 9 times a kilogram gives you the square meter? Something like that. Someone's probably there right now to click. Hang on, Dana. Hang on, Dana. Hang on, Dana. I'll do it on that calculator. 8-year-old girl has 3,000 disintegrations. No. Dying 8-year-old girl. That's how that headline should be. Has 3,000. Now, she drinks some more water, she gets 3,017, and she gets a bath, she got 3,115, and she goes out and she makes some Kool-Aid and drinks it, she gets 3,290, and the numbers just keep going up. And if you eat a banana, you off-gas the exact same amount, because that's potassium 40, and it got no room in this conversation, but they tell you all the time, wow, it's like a banana, it's like a potato chip, and walking in the sunshine, and get on here. Planes, and by that time they're picking up their teeth out of the side of their head. I'm just saying, if they're telling it to me, they're on TV. Well, we got Mr. Durnford in this chair, we got Mr. Bootlicking cheerleading lapdog for the nuclear industry in that chair. And Dan, I don't know what your problem is, man. I got a banana, but I'm gonna bring a banana with me so I don't hit him. I can jam the banana up his nose. Yeah, I'm gonna get arrested, but. It's going to be a good headline. Nowhere to see. Cesium levels. Now, mushrooms love cesium. Yummy cesium. Yummy. You see mushrooms on sale all the time now. 3,000 becquerels a kilogram. Someone tries to give you mushrooms, run away and lock yourself in the closet. Already eaten by hundreds of children. Yummy little. Here you go, you little demons. You'll be making the pharmaceutical industry so happy in a few years, yeah. Mommy and Daddy will liquidate everything to keep your little precious alive. High radioactivity fell all around the skulls. 30 kilometers from Tokyo. 30 kilometers from Tokyo. And over a dozen hot spots detected. I got kicked off today. Did I get kicked off? Huh? Did I, huh? Did I? Don't talk about kids, Dana. Let me keep going. Chat kept going. Don't talk about Tokyo, Dana. I guess they edited out some of the headlines in the journal live stream here. Kooky little bez. Let's keep going. I got a really good connection. It's dedicated to me, and I'm on a reasonable stream itself. There's been doing this a long time. Anyways, 50 becquerel a kilogram in humans lead to irreversible lesions in the vital organ. I said organ. You can call it whatever you want. It's full of radiation. You can have it. High radioactivity found all around the school. 30K. Over a dozen hotspots detected near face level. So the radioactive atoms, you'll hear them in the comments section. Wow, it's really heavy. It falls out of the sky right away. No, it doesn't. It just hovers close to the ground. Like a mist hovers, like fog hovers. But where Timmy's whacking his skull, could be a million becquerels in a square meter around him. Don't mind me, I get a little cokey sometimes. That's just my personality. I'm like that in real life. Just like this in real life. This is me. See, that's the problem. I got to learn to stop doing all of the My friends just call it antiques. Dana's in these antiques. They're always laughing their butts off anyway. Journalist finds Tokyo indoor dust contaminated with cesium. After settlement, 130. But it's like a banana, Dana. Pop! Scientists, dust from Fukushima fallout is the source of the human radiation exposure. Am I telling you 500 more times? Japan blog author claims medical workers said malformed babies are declared stillbirth or miscarriages. Stop yelling, Dana. Okay. Not including statistics. See, I always get this silly when I do the kids, right? And I was like, all morning I've been like this. Because I don't like this one. This bugs me. Fukushima women losing their hair. They don't need hair. Women are naturally beautiful. They don't need hair. Praise be surrounded by women. Resemblance to chemotherapy? Yeah. Well, what chemotherapy does is they kill all the cells in the hope that they don't leave any cancer cells and that your body will regenerate the cells and then your hair grows back. Oh, yeah, man. I kid you not. That's their theory on it. They're going to kill you anyway. They dose you with that, you're a dead man walking. And so 2% of the people that get chemotherapy survive any longer than they would have without getting it. So chemotherapy is when, you know, you sign this piece of paper and it says that they can stick a 2x4 up your chummy and walk around with you till you die and you can't sue them. Dana surely come up with something better than that. Not really, though. That's pretty well what they're doing to you. Tokyo official blasts his parents who wants kids to avoid ingesting radioactivity in school. It's important to share the pain. You go bang, bang, bang. Did you get it off? Oh, bang. I never heard you. Sorry, what? Bang. Now you're sharing the pain. Ha ha ha. Here. Get up off the ground. Go wash your face. You're making the kids nervous. You'll be sharing pain. You say something like that. You got no idea. Japan lawmaker, 180,000 students might have eaten radioactive beef. Might have. I'm not saying they ate it. You go out and tell them they ate it. No, I go out there. Okay, go and say they might have eaten it or may have eaten it. But for Christ's sakes, don't say they ate it. No, because then they'll find out. They'll look back and find out we've been doing this from the beginning to them. And it was much higher. 180 dead men walking students. Anyway, professor detects 104 microsievers near where kids walk to school. TEPCO's not going to go out there and look for it. They know what's there. They flew over one of those planes you bought them. I'm not going in there. What, for a photograph? No. No. I'm going to retire next year. I might get my pension. You're probably not. Absurd reality where children are right next to the highest levels imaginable. The most carcinogenic thing on the planet imaginable. 11 Becquerels, you'll see problems manifesting with their heart and their respiratory. 50 Becquerels, permanent damage. And they're allowed to eat just like yummy. Well, they say, oh, I'm not allowed to get no more than 100 Becquerels in a kilogram of food. Yeah, well, 50 is permanent damage to your organs. Lesions to your organs. Hospital doctor says patients suffering high-level radioactive exposure and complains the media is not reporting his findings. No, because it's... He never said the magic words. Bananas and potato chips. Go ahead, Zoe. Jump. Jump. You okay? Hang on. Hang on, folks. Did you hurt yourself a couple of days ago? Is that why you won't jump the last couple of days?
Yeah.
No. I don't feel any lumps on you.
Yeah.
You okay?
She's not me Zoe, she was a few days ago. She's not jumping like she normally jumps. Dana, you okay, goof? Don't sit on the router, Zoe. If you kick your leg now, you're going to disconnect the router. I always put the router down low. Let me play a video and I'll come over and I'll deal with her real quick. What have I got for everybody anyway? Let me see. I know I got stuff here I haven't played. But Oh, yeah, that's MIT. Here's what MIT said on March the 15th, 2011 about the reactors. It's a different story than what the media told you, and we'll go back to the headlines right away, but because we're talking about media, I wanted to show you what the actual academics come out and admitted to it, even though the scientists from these institutions have come out and mocked anybody concerned about it. But a couple of days after the accident, they had a press conference. A press conference! All the major ones did. And I covered all the major institutions all the time, because unfortunately, that's where evil emanates from, and I've covered that many times. Here we go. Just a short 1 minute clip, I believe. Here we go.
I'd like to welcome our own students from Nuclear Science and Engineering and other members of the community here at MIT, and also visitors, I think, from elsewhere.
And shortly after 3:30, there was a hydrogen explosion in the building of Reactor 1. So when of that explosion? Not long after, the evacuation zone was extended to 20 kilometers radius. On Monday at 11 a.m., so this is now on the third day, there was a hydrogen explosion of building of Reactor 3. In the meantime, Reactor 2 fuel rods, what is reported to have been fully uncovered, and they quite soon began to inject seawater, borated seawater. At 6:14 a.m. on Tuesday, that's today, of course, but since they're 13 hours ahead of us, that was quite a while ago now, there was a third explosion. This was in Reactor 2. This was inside, as far as we can tell, inside or near the containment. And another worry that arose was on that same day was that the Reactor 4 building, Reactor 4 is adjacent to Reactor 3, was observed to be aflame. And this was sort of at the same time that radiation levels were increasing further. There was a lot of suspicion that this fire was in the spent fuel pool. However, since that time, TEPCO has said that there was an oil leak in a water pump and that that was what was the cause of the fire.
Right, so I jimmied all that together, all the pictures in it. I took it out of their presentation. And I've covered that many times on this site. So let's run back to the headlines and keep moving, because we're running out of time again. And time flies. Less than 25 minutes. 51% of the kids examined were contaminated with cesium-137, but a couple of weeks ago, a study came out saying there's 2,700 children tested, and they never had no manifestations of autoimmune deficiencies. The cancer takes a long time to show up. It can't just show up right away, but it has in heavy, extraordinary cases. Alpha radiation detected on School Street in Minnesota. Now, on the School Street. Now, we know this place had up to 1 million becquerels a square meter in this community. Think about the ramifications for Tokyo. How would you like kneeling in radioactive waste to pick flowers, to tie your shoes, or to pick up your change that you dropped, or that your children are meandering their way through on the way to school, kicking away at, you know, just incredible amounts of radiation, mud puddles, and just sediment and dirt. Cobalt-60 in majority of the samples, up to... just cobalt. I mean, if you got one there, you got another couple of thousand radioactive isotopes there. And the Geiger counters, you would need 2,000 Geiger counters calibrated to 2,000 isotopes. And 2,000 people trained to use each one of those Geiger counters and how to look and detect and observe and properly, you know, source out. An enormous undertaking on its own, yeah? The children are the sacrifices. The businesses forces the mayor to keep the children here. That's 25 kilometers away. That's just their sacrifice, yeah. A school had children clean up highly contaminated areas and relocate the dirt. They had them clean up. They knew what they were doing, right? They knew exactly what they were doing. Go out there and clean it up so you don't accidentally go out there and get some on your hands. Right? You know, the parallels that they're drawn... is my instant reaction would be to go down and throttle everybody in the classroom, everyone of those teachers with all the parents, and throw them out the window and tell them they're fired. That's a polite way of saying what I would do to them. You don't want the kids to go out, you put a fence there and keep them away from it. You don't make them go out and pick it all up. Yeah? Yeah? Would you, like, if there was something dangerous there, would you tell your kid to go pick it up and put it somewhere else because you didn't want them to accidentally pick it up? Like I say, I can snap when it comes to these topics sometimes. I get pretty angry. 80% of residents tested strong emotional attachments to the human species. And so it offends me when people do this. Because the effects are not immediate all the time. It could take 5 years, 10 years, 2 weeks. Some residents face potential health risks from exposure. Some. 80% tested radioactive iodine in the thyroids. It has an extra electron attached to it. It has a different atomic weight. There's nothing on the planet has an autoimmune system that can deal with it, and that it assaults the body. The body attacks it as a foreign object, floods the body with white blood cells for 20 years, displacing the oxygen. Right? So a single atom in you is catastrophic to your body function. It sequesters there, and you can't get rid of it. You can't just... You can chelate it, but whatever. Radioactive cesium causing holes in hearts, you can't get it all out, is what I'm saying. Just a single atom is the cancer showing up down the road. The more you got, the worse it's going to be, the quicker the diagnosis of autoimmune deficiencies, but not associated. Because everybody's, like, cancer is only one out of 1,800 things that can happen to you. There's many types of cancers, don't get me wrong, and it's going to happen. Because your body is hard at it for 20 years to build a sarcophagus, and you need one of them or a tumor around it before you can be diagnosed. Radioactive cesium causing holes in the hearts of children. But if it gets in your pelvis, it's mutating the stem cells right away. It just takes years for it to show up and manifest and get diagnosed. And liquidating your assets. Radioactive cesium causing holes in the hearts of children. Holes in the hearts of children. Now, once again, Dana, don't harm children. Stop saying it, Dana. Look, Dr. Raymond Gill made his studies on the beagle dogs and the beagle puppies for 35 years, has a lot more weight to it than a study on fruit flies. Uh-huh. Right? Yeah? Yeah, we can all kind of like agree on something maybe, huh? Radiation really truly is. They have to lie for 70 years to keep it alive. They have to lie about every aspect of it. Oh no, it's... Like, you give your kids bananas, you don't give them radioactive cesium from a nuclear reactor. I hope you don't, anyway. Controversy after U.S. government estimated showed 40,000 microsieverts thyroid doses for the California infants, right? And there was a mass die-off of infants in a couple of months, an abnormality in the yearly stats for that month. It was just like a big, huge, massive spike. Because the jet streams are real. We covered that a couple of episodes ago. They're real. Yeah. I call up the Weather Channel and ask them. Pretty hard to beat me on that one. 80% of residents are screwed. Iodine 132. For every iodine 131, there was 10 times more iodine 132. And 30 times more iodine 133. And 31 times more iodine 129 with a 15 million year half-life. Have a nice day. No, iodine did. Oh, iodine. Doesn't that disappear in 8 days? Yeah, that's what he told you. Now I got to tell you, the iodine 129, 31 times more of it for every iodine 131. So babies born this year may be working at Fukushima Daiichi one day. Is that not a frightening and unimaginable headline? Yeah. Face TEPCO. It won't be TEPCO's kids working there, I can assure you. Worse than radioactive rain after Fukushima, fallout was suspended near the Earth's surface without settling down. And so, when they detonate nuclear weapons in Iraq, there was a cloud hanging over Iraq for 6 days. This was the dirty bombs. This is what a nuclear, like bullets, you know, depleted uranium munitions, they're dirty bombs. You fire that in someone's country, that's a dirty bomb. Oh, they might come and explode a dirty bomb in our country, Dana. They might steal it from Mexico or from a hospital. Yeah, but You go down there and you burn up 5.5 million bullets a month. Half of that is dirty bombs. For 9 years. To get 10,000 gangbangers. Taliban. Millions dead, millions missing, millions in refugee camps, millions of orphans. To get 10,000 gangbangers. I support the trope. 290,000 rapes in the last decade in the military. Raping their own. How many are raping in Iraq and Afghanistan and everywhere else they go? They're going to rape almost 300,000 of their own in a decade. I can assure you they're raping everybody's children down there. And if an occupying force come to my community and rape my children, I can assure you I would be their resistance. Yeah? And if they shot a bullet in everybody's home in your country, you'll all be the resistance. Yeah? Because you got no option, right? Children playing on dirt with huge amounts of radioactivity, including D-alpha emitters. Cesium levels so high, prevent identification of other isotopes. It's okay, though. It's just Tokyo. That's Tokyo, boy. Tokyo's always like that. That's just radon, Dana. It's just, they're sitting on a whole bunch of potassium-40, Dana. I'm just mimicking all the comment sections and the PR firms that are attacking me out all over the web. Japan every day, nonstop, relentlessly. Anybody leaves a comment on my videos or any video out there gets an email smearing the crap out of me. These people are organized. They're watching you forever after that. And you comment somewhere, they're going to come in and pat you on the back if they said something you liked. If you said something they liked. 90% of the urine samples contaminated with cesium in a city 200 kilometers from Fukushima. Do you got any idea what that means? Probably not, eh? There's like a banana, Dana. There's no longer any such thing as clean and safe food. Means that for sure. After radiation from Fukushima spread around the planet, Oh, no, Dana stayed right around the planet. Stayed inside the fence, Dana. Stayed inside the barriers, Dana. People who advance nuclear power should be made to eat the extremely contaminated items. I want a spoon fade up. I want to be a person that fade. I don't care if I'm breathing it. I want to watch your eyes light up when I turn green. Japan resident Tokyo area sample. Cesium gamma single so strong. Everybody ran away. No, you can't write that down. Okay. Unable to identify other isotopes. Write that down. Okay, I write that down. But, yeah, honey, was that true? I read your article. I don't know. I ran. Everybody else was running. Talking about newspaper. 6 in 10 Fukushima children tested of diabetes. So diabetes is a direct relation to radioactive elements. You see diabetes spike around all nuclear power plants. Downwinders, it spikes dramatically. It showed up dramatically right after nuclear was invented, nuclear testing. You know, they got to mine 400 train car loads to get a gram of uranium, right? Oh, but coal's dirty. Stanford publication. TV, were TV experts paid to say Fukushima? Well, some Stanford scientists were too. They actually had a small leak when it was the largest in the world, in the planet, in the entire universe, in the entire solar system. Local official, 5 million becquerels a kilogram, no decontamination, we can't eat the food. That's okay, we got a black market for that. Well, we'll just change the laws and make other countries take it. That's what we'll do. We're going to take it, I don't care. We're not going to lose a nickel because of this. We'll make them eat it. That's what they're doing. No one hold them accountable. You, like the big corporations, Google can't, Eric Schmidt can't go to jail and get a criminal record. No. He broke every crime in the book out there. He violated everybody's privacy on the planet. He's the biggest crook imaginable. But he can't get a criminal record because he's a corporation. Corporate personhood. All you can do is give them fines. Not a criminal record, though. Can't go to jail. You're going to do the same thing up at the internet right now? You're going to jail. They'll demonize you till the end of time. They'll do documentaries on the History Channel of how twisted you were. You had no life sitting there with your computer. But yet, these people do it for a living. Wreck countries, wreck economies. Just disgusting. 10 million backwards. You grab those teachers, you run up there and you drag them through that and run away. Just run away. You don't have to do anything else. Just maul them with that for a few moments. Just drag them through it. Say, yeah, you're done. See you, dickhead. Just leave him there. He's dead in a couple of years. Hi, shit. 6 million becquerels a kilogram in black substance. Just what? Just like all of these headlines are like, what? This is the frighteningest. Like, if this was in my country, that whole community, they would dig it up and put it on a nuclear waste site. If your whole country like it, you just dig it up, pretend you're doing something, bring it to another prefecture, put it in an incinerator, reliberate it back into the environment. That's the worst shell game I've ever saw, but probably the best one because everybody fell for it. They're still falling for it. For a little bit longer, anyway. It's all going to come to a head soon, though. You can't keep hiding the death of the Pacific Ocean. Well, we got 10 minutes. Let's keep moving. Tokyo professor, cesium detected in the urine of the Fukushima infants. Oh, no, I got no effect on the human body. Here's some cesium they got from a terrorist. Go ahead, let me see you drink it. Huh? I got to go find out who this guy, this Tokyo professor is. I got to find that guy. Anyway, I got to call him up and tell him something. It ain't going to be pretty. I'll put it up on YouTube if I can get him. I am going to find that guy and call him. Just rather than yelling and screaming that time, I decided I'm going to call that guy up. I'm going to ask him some serious questions, too. Just man old man old, you know? Just 0.8% of children in 2001. Japanese control group had thyroid cysts or nulge. 36% in the Fukushima study. That was Las Vegas odds. You'll be betting on that one, wouldn't you? You'd be like, yeah, I'm liking it. Give them some more. I know some suckers out there I can put bets in on. Children swim at the Fukushima beach. A million becquerels at that beach in the seaweed was regular. But, I mean, that's just cesium. There's another million of this and a million of that and another million of these and another million of that. They don't just travel by themselves. There's thousands of them. They only tell you about cesium and iodine for 70 years. Can't have a conversation with anybody. Oh, it's cesium! Japanese journalists, do they want to kill children? Adults in Tokyo are insane. Watch nursery school children on contaminated playground equipment. The radiation is in the holes. No dosimeters. Do you think a kid knows what a dosimeter is? Huh? Do ya? Nothing more scary than seeing a bunch of kids marching off to school with dosimeters. This can't be any worse. Imagine being a mailman, you know, all these kids going past you with dosimeters and you're new on a job from another prefecture and you're always eating up TV, not paying attention. Like, how'd they get this job, I wonder? Well, the last guy had a heart attack. Red Cross team, I guarantee you that happened a couple of times on a few streets. Not just once in the whole country, but a few times on the same street. Red Cross team, where some mailman had this epiphany. We were told by headquarters not to provide medical care for those exposed to radiation. Huh? In touch with Red Cross. Vacant, strong, and free. Bum, bum, bum. Japanese author, extreme increase in mortality caused by cardiac diseases. Because the cesium attacks your heart. Yummy heart. Nom, nom, nom. Yum, nom, nom, nom. Eat heart. Yum, yum, yum. Cesium. And there's so much released down there, I've just been goofy at this stage because I'm going to scream. Everybody down. Death rate might give the creeps to some people. I can think of a few other things gives the creeps to some people. Begins with a T. Ends with an O. How do you keep TEPCO out of your garden? You hang one of them from your front garden. Alice in Wonderland was used to convince children in Japan nuclear power is safe. No, it's okay. Now it's normal to have a million becquerels a square meter in your playground, Timmy. So who done it? Uploaded by Harvard. Charles Ferguson, President Foundation, Federation of American Scientists. If you go look up his history, you'll find him talking about bananas everywhere, but this story probably got to him. And you just, like, that whole presentation, you would have found bananas or potato chips or walking in the sunshine somewhere in it. That's what Harvard does, right? I'm Harvard, and I'm from the best institution on the planet. Pregnant women used for decontamination activity. They're attacking the kids. They're trying to kill the kids off. There's no doubt about it. Japan wants to get little cartoon characters and replace the kids with them, so they're going to get rid of all the kids so they can all be going around in their cosplays with little children androids. And then they, I mean, Japan's the only country that sells, you know, little teenage girls' panties and vending machines like Coke, right alongside the Coke vending machines at malls and shopping malls and everywhere else. And schools. It's just like, what? Get them when they're fresh, I guess. You got some six, that's a sick society, so it's not a really big surprise you're doing this to the children. They don't care about the children. They care about themselves only. And if there's a hair part on their head, they care about that. Thyroid cancer risk lasts the entire life after radiation. Well, thyroid, you can kill that gland, right? It's a gland. So it's a, right? So it's a dead gland, so it rots in your body then. That's why people die of it. It's a hard one to transplant, but they can. Writers! We'll end on this one here. Fukushima mom, 5 hospitals refuse to provide medical care to children. Huh? Did I get a good headline or not? For Tom, is that not a good one to go out on? We can't be seen by a doctor when we want to be seen. It's just not right. And the doctor said it'd be confusing if our results are different than in Fukushima Medical University. Well, doctor, I don't think anybody got to worry about that because you're not going to have a different one, are you? Well, yeah. I miss Milky. That's Jan Brooks. Jan Brooks doesn't stop. And she's got an amazing site there with an amazing amount of information, of narratives, every narrative in the book there. You can hear it from the horse's mouth at Jan, Miss Milky's site. And you'll find links below my video, many other people. And should you know, I never mentioned Radchik enough, Christina Consolo. And you'll find links to her and Lorraine Moret below anyway, but Kevin Blanche and everybody else out there. I do what I can do all the time. I'm constantly shoving everybody all the time. That's just who I am, I guess. Chuck, Stan, fix it. Gesture says ozone depletion is a result of atmospheric testing. Well, when stuff goes up from an accident or just the releases, because they're so tiny, they can linger in the upper troposphere for decades, and they go even higher into the upper stratosphere, and they will cause damage constantly all the time. And these are pure energy, so they will heat up a glass of water. And so the more you put in, the more heat they're going to generate, but they'll heat up that glass of water forever. At some point, you're going to have to add water because it'll evaporate off constantly. The more you add in. That's how the fuel pool works at Fukushima's and every other reactor. And once again, remember that tsunami ran through the coastline and that earthquake ran through the whole coastline and that none of the reactors on the coastline are reopened. The ones on the other side, on the west side, the east side, was wiped out by that tsunami, right? And there's 14 reactors down, originally reported on it. And so fix it, Rattleshark, Bob. You lost your stream for a period? Of course you did. I'm recording it right here. And so I'll have a look and maybe I'll post that section up if necessary. You're welcome, folks. Thank you, Starlight. And Sterling's making fun of the industry. Thomas Ackerman. You find Thomas links below too. 11 Brand 11. Thank you. Albert. Adam. Chuck. And everybody else. You got a really busy week coming up. Do the Richie Allen Show Wednesday, 12:20 p.m. Pacific Canada time, right here, British Columbia time. And then we're doing Beaver Radio on Friday, I think. I better check my emails. And then we got Karen on Saturday, I think. And then we got Lonnie on Monday radio shows. So we got four more radio shows to get through this week. And I don't know any of your sites, so I apologize. I'm just so busy. I'll try to get up to speed, but I got so much to get through. And anyway, I changed. You can go to my site, nuclearproctologist.org. Hang on, I'll bring that up for you. Just so anybody's watching this, never got the data of where I'm to and how to find these streams every day at 10 Pacific Canada time. You'll find it at the Beautiful Girl by Dana. Go over to my site and go to uploads. Click on that. Go to live streams. You'll get this. I'm that one there in the corner. And so if I refresh the page, if I refresh that page, it'll say live there now, live now. But there's a preamble with a countdown timer on there, usually 10, 12 hours before the stream starts. It's 10:30 a.m. Pacific Canada time, British Columbia time, 5 days a week. And this is my website, thenuclearproctologist.org. You got a couple of different sections where we've done 5 expeditions on the coastline. Section 2 is what you're looking at right now. That's the recent expedition. And there's only 2 algaes. There's kelp cabbage and kelp weed. And that's kind of symmetrical throughout the whole coastline. But if you come down, you'll see all kinds of pictures. And that was Zoe, who was making all that racket over there. I had to get up and go put her down on the ground. She's 15 years old. And that's because I'm constantly paying attention to her. And that's why she lived 15 years. I watch her all the time to make sure she doesn't get ran over, blah, blah, blah. I don't let her out of my sight for the most part. And vice versa, trust me. So you can come down, look at the pictures, just click on the pictures or the headlines down below and meander through it yourself. And you click either side, left or right. You don't have to be right on the arrow. And so I'll come back in and say goodnight to everybody. I just wanted to make sure I put out there, like you say, there's 200 pictures on each of these pages. And you go to the top of the nuclear proctologist sections. The first sections, the first set of links are lots of headlines there too. But there's thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of pictures of the coastline of Canada that we've done 260 days on the ocean over the last 365 days. And so we flushed this out really well. Hugs for everybody, Chuck, Thomas, Daniel, LA. We see Elaine is out there, I know. Terry Ann is out there. I hope you woke up, Terry. I know you were off doing other things. Candace, we know. Brenda, I can't get the comments to work proper. Fans, Chuck, everybody, have faith. Nev Killer, and everybody else. Post links to the interviews. And, oh yeah, okay, Miss Melky, I'll try. Yeah, good point, Dana. Yeah, I never even thought about it, to tell you the truth. No, we'll get links for you. I think I've been asking people to send me the links anyway when you put it up. If I can find it. My email is kind of like the comment section on my video, where it's just, but I get to everybody. I find everything, no matter, I go through all the stuff that went in the junk email, I go through all of that too. I make sure if anybody's reaching out trying to talk to me or ask me a question or anybody that's out there and is trying to get my attention, I give them every opportunity in the book. My phone number's on my website. You can call me. Can't get me any other way. If you got to want to talk to me, if you got to get an answer and you think I might be able to help you, I'll try. That's all I can say, right? It's just that I don't stop. Hi, Zenny. Thank you. Good night, everybody. Thanks for spending the time cracking corn. Freak, Jimmy Joe, and everybody else out there, Amters, and everybody that has supported the Fukushima expedition. Don't think I ever forget about you because I don't mention you all the time. It's just not enough time to do it all. That doesn't mean I won't keep bringing it up every so often, because I will, because that is my life. And my family and my friends is right here with me today. Always got my back, is another way of putting it. And it's a good thing, because I was on the ocean 260 days out of 365. If you didn't have my back, the trolls would have definitely been bored out of their minds, because they were going to have me one way or another. So hugs for everybody. Take care, folks.
The Fukushima catastrophe is probably the worst nuclear disaster in human history. It's certainly worse than Chernobyl. The contamination from Fukushima has gone as far south as Tokyo. I have measured it personally in air filters from cars. At least 12 different air filters from cars were sent to me, some of them from the south of Tokyo, and many of them from 100 kilometers away from Fukushima. And they contain very large amounts of radioactivity in them, high levels of cesium-134 and cesium-137. So we can conclude without any doubt that that area, up to 200 kilometers, maybe more, away from the catastrophe site, has been seriously contaminated with radionuclides. Now, if the cars are breathing this material, then so are the people, and so are the children. And so the children will be contaminated with radioactivity. We've recently heard that the Japanese government have been doing whole body counting, that is to say they've been putting some people inside a monitor to see how much cesium is inside them. And apparently the levels of cesium are sufficient for them to say that there's no problem, that there are not going to be any increases in ill health. At the same time I hear reports from Japan, from mothers of children, who say that they're showing all of the signs of contamination with cesium that were also found by my colleague Professor Yuri Bandashevsky after Chernobyl in the areas of Belarus that were contaminated similarly with this substance, cesium-137. And what it did there was that it went into the heart muscle and it caused conduction difficulties and destroyed heart muscle. So the children in Belarus were suffering heart attacks and arrhythmias. That's when the heart doesn't beat properly. And of course, later on in life, they die young from heart disease because the heart cells don't replicate themselves. The heart cells, you get all of your heart cells at once. You get maybe 1% increase in heart cells per year. But over the period of time we're talking about, there's going to be no replacement for the cells that were damaged by the Fukushima catastrophe in the children. So we have two different points of view here. We have the point of view of the Japanese government, who are ignoring it, who are making these superficial measurements of cesium in the whole bodies of the children and the people, and are saying that these concentrations are not sufficient to cause any problems. Well, of course, this is an argument that's going on and on. It's like a tennis match, goes backwards and forwards. You know, the independent scientists say there's a problem, and the government and the nuclear scientists say there's no problem. Of course, the real problem is that we have to do something about it. I mean, I am a father. I have 7 children. I have 11 grandchildren. And I can't sit back and just let this go on with us in some sort of silly tennis match between us and the pro-nuclear scientists who are trying to save the industry from collapse. And all the time, the children are getting more and more sick, and they're building up this level of radioactive damage, which will result in them getting sick and dying with cancer, heart disease, whole range of illnesses that were all discovered after Chernobyl. And it's not as if this is something new. We know what's going to happen. We absolutely know what's going to happen. We have looked very closely at the health effects of people who were exposed to these same radionuclides after the Chernobyl accident in the same quantities. Not as many people, I have to say, which is why Fukushima is a worse disaster. So I decided we had to do something, and I was contacted by some people in Japan who said, what can we do? So instead of just moaning about it, we decided to do something. Now, there are actually some things that we can do. The first thing we can do is we can actually measure the radionuclides ourselves, because frankly we do not believe what the Japanese government is coming out with. We don't think that they're right. I mean, I've measured more radioactivity in a car air filter than they are measuring in a child. And the car breathes air in the same way as the child breathes air, so I don't really believe what they're saying. That's the first point. So we need to have independent testing. And secondly, we need to try and do something about these children who are being contaminated. There are two things we can do. The first thing is we can take them away from the areas of contamination and put them somewhere where it's reasonably safe. But that leads us to another problem, because what's happening now, as I'm told, is that the Japanese government are trucking radioactive material from the Fukushima disaster area where it's contaminated all over Japan. And even as far south as the south of Japan, we're now getting reports of radioactive material being taken all the way to the south of Japan to be burnt. Now, what possible reason could there be for burning it as far away as that? I'll tell you the reason. It's really quite sinister and horrifying. The reason is this, that eventually when these children start to die from leukemia, from other cancers, from heart disease, from whatever, their parents are going to want to go into court. They're going to want to sue the Japanese government, and they're going to want to have to say, in order to do that, these children were contaminated, and that's why they've got high levels of cancer. But of course, the only way that they can say that they've got high levels of cancer is to have a control group in an area that's not contaminated. For example, the south of Japan. So I believe that the project to take this material and burn it all over Japan is to destroy all of Japan, is to increase the cancer rate in the whole of Japan so that there will be no control group to which you can compare these children in the Fukushima area. So that's that point. So we want to take the children away anyway into some safe area. That's what we want to do. But the second thing that we can do, and this is also quite important, is we can try and block the material. We can try and block the absorption of the cesium and the absorption of the strontium-90 and the plutonium and the other substances that are not being measured, incidentally. We have to wait a minute now because there's a train passing. I'm sitting on a children's playground here in Sweden. This is in Stockholm. And I decided to talk to you from here, from Stockholm, where there is a significant amount of radioactivity as well, I have to say, in the Baltic Sea. I measured this myself, but that's another question. So the second thing we can do is we can try and block the ingress of the radioactivity into the child's body. Now, we know that we can do this with iodine, because iodine goes to the thyroid gland. We give them stable iodine, or at least we're supposed to. It turns out the Japanese government didn't. And then it stops the bad iodine, the radioactive iodine, from binding to the same sites. And you can do the same thing with the other radionuclides. For uranium and plutonium and strontium-90, which are the most serious, and all of which they're not measuring, incidentally, and none of which can be measured with a whole body counter, because they're alpha emitters or beta emitters, we can block their attachment to the DNA by giving large amounts of calcium and magnesium, which binds to the DNA and keeps the strontium and the uranium off the DNA. So that's one thing that these children can do. They can take a tablet every day of stable calcium. And so we are going to produce tablets which contain stable calcium, which we will supply cheaply at the cost of production to parents of these children so that they can take these tablets and block the ingress of these substances. And we're also working on another tablet which will block the ingress of cesium-137. Now, in order to do this, we have set up an organization in Japan called the ChristopherBusby Foundation for the Children of Fukushima. And it has a website, and it's all in Japanese, and it's all being done by a colleague of mine who contacted me from Japan, called James Grand. In addition to this, we are going to purchase a large number of highly sophisticated radiation measuring devices from Europe, from suppliers in Europe and suppliers in the Ukraine. And we're going to make these devices available to the parents of children to measure the concentrations of these substances in the food, and also to supermarkets, and we will measure the substances ourselves. We will set up a laboratory in Japan so that people can bring these substances to the laboratory and find out the truth about the concentration of radionuclides in these substances. So these are the things that we want to do, and we want you to help us to do this in any way that you can. This is an operation to save the children of Fukushima, because we do not believe that the Japanese government is doing anything to save the children of Fukushima. They are operating on a principle which is the principle of saving not the children of Fukushima, but the international nuclear industry. And this is disgraceful. Thank you for listening.